The Bible says in Romans chapter 5 from verse 12 to 21, by one man, Adam, we were all condemned, but by one man, he brought salvation unto us. And that one man that brought salvation unto us is Jesus Christ. Why? Men, we are still living, but men, we are dying. We are dying spiritually. Why? Because except those who have faith in God, like Abraham then. If you didn't have faith then forget it. Oh, God, help me. If you didn't have faith in God in the olden days, forget it. That is where faith, that is why our salvation is by faith in Christ Jesus. You know why God actually came? He came so that man will no longer have the audacity and the effrontery and the excuse to say, God, you're up there. Do you even know what we are suffering? Do you know how difficult it is to be a man? No. That's why he came down. It's one of the reasons why he came down. So that he would live the life of a man and prove to us that it is possible for man to stay tuned to God, fellowship with the Father, live a just and faithful life in God, and die and attain immortality with Christ. Immortality is what God had put for us. That is his original plan before the enemy stepped in. And so every day of our lives on this earth, the flesh is waging war. It wants to have a higher advantage over our spiritual man. Yes. And unfortunately, most of us keep yielding to it. And the more we yield, notice this, the more you yield to flesh, to the carnal things of mind, the more we are conformed to the things of this world, the lesser the frequency of our spirit. That's why some people will say, you can't go to a party where they're saying, grace, okay. And then you come back immediately and you want to pray. You cannot tune in. You cannot finish gossiping and quarreling with your fellow man or neighbor. And you want to come and sing praises unto God. No, forget all those people that if they're quarreling with you, they'll be singing and it's a song of quarrel. Those ones are not even part of our discussion. You see, so the higher we give, we conform into, you know, to the likeliness and the things that the flesh love and the world as a whole, the lower we are tuned, our spirit man is tuned unto God. And thereby, we now ask, what is the status of our, I now ask, and we can ask ourselves, what is the status of our spirit man? Hey, there's somewhere around here that I'm going to show you a picture of a skeleton and a man. It's going to be in clip art form. Some people have their spirit man is starved. Kai, it is starved. It has been starved to the point that even United Nations cannot even help. Seriously. Their spirit man is skeletal, like in the form of skeleton, while their flesh is chubby, like if you see chubbiness, is almost over. Oh, is getting obese. The flesh is getting obese. That's the word I was looking for. But the spiritual man is starved. My fellow believers, brethren, it is time for us. I'm not saying it is not okay for you to look good and all of that, but it is time we need to feed our spirit man. It is time we need to stuff up our spirit man. I present to us another example of a bread. Between an ordinary loaf or bread and Burger King double whopper, you know, double whopper, there's meat, there's vegetable, there's cheese, there's onions, there's all of that. Which one would you prefer? Which one would you prefer? Everyone wants to go for what is good. If we know what is good, how come we are starving our spirit man of the word of God? If God brings his onyokometer now, his microscope, some of us, our spirit man is 0.0.00. it doesn't even have weight on the weighing scale. Our spirit man does not have weight on the weighing scale. Why? Because we are starving it and we are feeding it with the things of flesh. cry, our prayer every day is, Holy Spirit of God, help us. Help us to feed our spirit man, that we may grow and be transformed unto the image of Christ. That should be our earnest prayer, for our spirit man to grow. I'm telling you the truth, that our status of spirit man should be healthy. I'm looking in here so that I don't miss the points I have. Romans 10:14 says, Brother Paul tells us to renew our mind in Romans 12:2. And it there means that the spirit man needs to feed on the word of God and stay under the hearing of faith to be quickened by the Holy Spirit in order to connect to God and know and do his perfect will. That is the major thing that God has always wanted for man, that will stay in immortality with him, doing and knowing and doing his will and fellowshipping with him. Kalas, finish. That's what he has always wanted us to do. And what is the status of our spirit man? Some will now come and say, my spirit man is skeletal because I don't know. Believers, so we are all called out to go and feed our spirit man. Yes, so every man is called to preach the good news unto the unbelievers and even to your fellow believers. Romans 10:14 says, I need to read it up because this is Bible study. If we do not open it, one might tend to miss out on a lot of things. Romans 10:14, and it says, how then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? One. And how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? And how shall they preach unless they are sent, as it is written? How beautiful are the feet of those who preach the gospel of peace, who bring glad tidings of good things. 16. But they have not all obeyed the gospel. For Isaiah says, Lord, who has believed our report? Note, Isaiah says, not said. So there are so many Isaiahs now saying right now, who has believed the report to obey the good news, to abide by the good news, to feed our spirit man with the good news? That is the only food that we need. We need the spiritual food. The word of God is the only food that benefits us physically, spiritually, emotionally, mentally, psychologically, and otherwise, because it is packed up with a lot of things, a lot of nutrition for man. It is what draws man onto the original plan of God. And so in any crooked ways or in any ways that man might have erred, this spiritual food, the word of God, is what straightens man up. It straightens us up, and as we continue to feed our spirit man, our frequency modulated band is increasing. That is, in other words, we are now highly tuned. Our inner man, our spirits and inner man is quickened, and then we now have the access to hear clearly of the word of God, of what the Lord is saying to the churches. Are we getting something here? That is our spirit man. And so please, the status of our spirit man needs to change. We don't want skeleton. The Lord does not want skeleton. As a matter of fact, if the spirit man can be obese, it is very important. Brother Paul says to Timothy, I think in 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse what? Chapter 4 from verse 1 to 2. First Timothy 1. Some people have seared their consciences with hot iron. We are so conformed into the things of the world that we have seared our consciences with hot iron. We no longer pay attention to our consciences. And so what it says, we don't even hear, not even to talk more of staying, you know, our frequency modulated band increasing. But Brother Paul says, I think he's in Timothy, I'm looking for that verse, that let us prosper even as our soul prospers, meaning that it's important that our soul prospers in the things of God. and it cannot prosper except by the word of God. This, remember that the soul is the yule, and it needs to gain it, it needs to feed from the side of the spirit man, that is, that has access to tune unto God. Are we getting this? And so quickly, I tend to mix these things up because I do not know how to go about explaining into details of what I really mean and what the Lord has really shown me. But I know that as time goes on, God is going to help me to continue to make His word very clear unto us. So I give an example of the bread and the whooper. We need to stuff our spirit man up. You know, the spirit man is the one that walks by spirit. We walk by, is the man that walks by faith and not by sight. Is the man that believes that Christ has come and died and is risen, and Christ has saved us and given us salvation. The spirit man is the man that walks, you know, by the word of God, that is the lamp unto our feet and the light unto our path. The spirit man is the man that knows that the Lord is his shepherd and he shall not want. The spirit man is the man that meditates upon the word of the Lord day and night. The spirit man is the man that says, I will stand upon my watch and I will hear of what the Lord will say to me. That's the spirit man. You are tuned, you are so tuned to what the spirit is saying to God that automatically you have overpowered your flesh. The flesh no longer has control over you and I. That is the spirit man. And so our spirit man needs to be palatable like the double whooper of Burger King, in a way that as we move, as we are moving and living our life on earth, people see us and begin to glorify God. As we are moving, the ooze and the aroma of the scent of the what we have received from the Spirit of God is able to change lives, is able to make difference, is able to draw the souls of men unto God. Hallelujah. So that is the spirit man, a man that does not walk by flesh, doesn't obey flesh. It's a man who obeys the Spirit of God, a man who is a soldier of Christ, a man who has said, we die here. He has so received from the Holy Spirit that, you know, he has overpowered his flesh. And the Spirit of God is, you know, the things of God is what saturates his heart, is what saturates his mind. Now, someone looking at this Burger King double whooper, I love Burger King double whooper because I'm always telling my husband to buy it for me. Yeah, you really need to see it. It's quite big and stuffed up, you know, with some other things that accompanies it, but we're not talking about double whooper here. I just cited that as an example. And someone would say, what can I stuff my heart with, or what can I stuff my soul with? Yeah, because the soul is the you that is in you, and it is made up of your mind. And remember that the mind is the channel. God is true. It is true, we can feel things, but if God wants to tell you something, he would drop it in your mind through your spirit man, right? So that's the channel. The enemy can still come into your mind too via the flesh. That's the truth. So what is it that we need to stuff in our mind, in our spirit man, so that in our soul, so that we are not conformed of the things of the world? There are lots of it. So I give it to us. We can stuff up our mind, that is, renewing it daily with the word of God. And this is not just about having three verses and you keep moving. In this coronavirus time, everybody's like, Psalm 91, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High. And then some people will be, I look up to the hills, 121, Psalm 121, whence cometh my help? And everything works out for good for they that love. Some people just scram and memorize all those verses and they keep chanting and repeating it. No, that's not what we're talking about. The spirit man meditates upon the word of the Lord day and night. Day and night. So we stuff up our mind. Well, I'm using the word stuff because I did not say if you feel it and is overflow, is get to the, if it gets to the point of overflow, so one might say stop. So I'm saying stuff. We continue to stuff it until we die. Sure, you know what is stuff. Stuffing is like, this thing is full, but I am still stuffing it in. So we keep packing it in until the day we close our eyes in death. So let's get to stuff up our mind with the word of God. Not just the three verses and chapters, but by getting rooted and grounded in the word and love of Christ Jesus. Remember, the word of God is a weapon. The spirit man is that man that, you know, wears the whole armor of God 24/7. And now that doesn't mean that there, you know, like we're not living as human beings. Yes, we live, we have our flesh to live by, but it then means that when you're a spirit man, so if your flesh can tell you, this is the latest Brazilian hair, this is the latest designer dress, I need to get it. But because your soul has received a lot and is still receiving from your spirit man that has access to the Holy Spirit of God, it is able to quench what your flesh is telling you at that time and says, my friend, move on. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Okay? So that does not mean that you will not eat though. Please, eat food though. Do exercise though. And all of that, it's important. We prosper, we are healthy. Who was that telling? I think telling Gaius, beloved, or something. I'll find it somewhere around here. But even if it's not, I think it was to an elderly man, Gaius, that Paul was telling. No, not Paul, I think John. That should be in 3rd John. Oh God, help me. Okay, eventually I hope that you find the scriptures and later I'll find it. But that our soul prosper it, that we are healthy and prosper even as our soul prosper it. So the number two thing we should stuff our mind with is praises and worship unto God. That's another weapon of its own. Remember, weapon of our warfare is not carnal, right? It's not something you can see. Praises and worship unto God. In Igbo, we say, you know, when you come into his presence, and by the way, God, we're always in the presence of God. So, but when you're praising and worshiping God, remember, worship is the gratitude lifestyle of a Christian, adoring God, you know, out of for loving him and for everything he has done for us and for who he is, basically. That's it. So when it's our lifestyle to praise and worship God, he is happy, and he rejoices. Yes, he is happy. And so, and not only that, by praise and worship we receive a lot from the Holy Spirit of God. That's the truth. A lot of things happen in the realm of the Spirit just by us praising and worshiping God with a sincere heart. Not because someone said, do 3 days fasting so that something will happen. It might happen, you know, but when we come in sincerity and out of thirst, you know, to reverence God, that's a different thing. Trust me. Now, the next thing we should stuff up our mind with is faith. Faith is like exercising our spiritual muscles. It is action based on God's word. If you have stuffed up your mind with the word of God, it is time to exercise your spiritual muscle by faith. That is what it is. Just like humans do exercise to keep faith, the spiritual man needs faith. It is exercising, you know, our belief in the word of God. That's what faith is all about. Stuff up your mind with testimonies. If we can always remember the testimonies of our Lord, we will forever and eternally remain grateful to him. A spirit man is that man who is forever grateful to God, knowing that he does not sleep nor slumber, and he keeps us. And he says that no matter the arrow that flieth by day nor by night, it shall not come near us. Many are the test are our testimonies, but we don't just see it because we are waiting for the big, big words. Count your blessings, name them one by one, and we will be surprised at what the Lord has done. Hallelujah. Let's also stuff up our mind with doing good. I have to make an emphasis on this. Our salvation is not by works, it's not by doing good. Doing good can make people glorify God, you know, when you do good at your side, and can draw the souls of men to God. Also, because as Christians, one of our characteristics, pardon me, is doing good. But it doesn't mean that anyone who does good is a Christian. No. The occultic men, now them do good, pastor. They are the ones that do good, even more than some of us that are Christians. But doing good is our characteristics. If you love the Lord, there's no how, if you're a Christian, there's no how you will not do good. But it does not mean that doing that anyone who does good and does not believe in Christ, does not have faith in Christ, is that person is not a Christian, is not a believer. I needed to make an emphasis on this. And next thing, we should ask the Holy Spirit to stuff up our mind with the fruits of the Holy Spirit. As in Galatians 5, I forgot to put it down, I think from 12 or so, but just check it out in Galatians 5. The fruit of the Holy Spirit: love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. We need to be filled. Our soul, our inner man needs to be filled with the fruit of the Holy Spirit. That is how we conquer. That is how we conquer the desires of the flesh, which is the pride of life, the lust of the eyes, and what other lust they get? Lust of the flesh. That's what you can summarize what the desires, you know, of the flesh is. Or rather, you know, the things of the world. So someone will say, that's hard. And I agree, but as we continue to trust the Holy Spirit of God, He is ever ready to help us. As we continue to trust the Holy Spirit of God, He's ever ready to help our spirit, our spirit man to be quickened and continue to grow, not to be a toddler. Some people are still toddlers. Christ called you. You are saved in the year 2035. We are now in 5027. You are still a toddler. Our spirit man needs to grow. We need to grow from baby to teenager to adulthood to man. We're at the point where God can say, like Abraham, in the case of Abraham, he is my friend. Or in the case of David, this is a man after my own heart. To that point where God can trust us and entrust us with, you know, with assignment of doing His will and, you know, drawing the souls of men unto Him. Our spirit man needs to always get nutrients from the Holy Spirit. We need to constantly feed from the Word of God and always feed from the Holy Spirit. These are the two channels that, you know, has been made obvious. The Word of God and the Holy Spirit, who is always here with us. These are the ways that we can feed our spirit man, so that our spirit man will grow and be mature, and of course be the man that someone would look at and also want to attain such height. There's something I wrote here, so let me just read it verbatim. We continue to trust the Holy Spirit to help us gain these fruits, and our mind is filled, will be filled with enriching spiritual knowledge and nutrients that is able to revive and nourish and replenish and develop our soul, so that we can be transformed daily onto the image of Christ. And so far, I want to trust God that someone, somewhere, at some time, got, even if it's one word, from today's Bible study. Thank you so much for staying tuned. But before we get to close it, let's say a prayer. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for this wonderful Bible study and gathering of the brethren. Our prayer is that you help us, O Lord, that we do not be conformed to the things of this world, O Lord, but that by the renewing of our mind and the word of God, that we are going to grow, and our spirit man, our soul will be transformed unto the image of Christ. Holy Spirit, we know it is hard, but we trust you to help us, be our reminder and teach us and remind us of Christ and everything we need to do to attain immortality in Christ Jesus, and to know and do the will of God our Father. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you so much for joining us. Please stay tuned and join us again for our next Bible study. Stay blessed, and you're the best.